This is Timmy. He joined an intro to computer science course and fell in love with coding. He thought he was doing everything right. He built impressive projects, aced his coding challenges, and added a sweet computer science degree to his resume. He bombarded every job application on LinkedIn, sending flattering emails every few weeks to his potential employers. A month went by, then two, then a year, yet no company got back to him. You definitely don't want to end up like Timmy. Here are the fatal mistakes he made. A solid foundation is-
Bro, I already know the basics, I wanna get to the fun stuff.
You may think that you're an expert and are way beyond the basics, but you need to be careful. Rushing through the basics or skipping them altogether can leave significant gaps in your knowledge. It'll also make it a lot harder grasping more complicated topics if you aren't comfortable with the basics. So take that extra half an hour if you don't understand a topic completely, and do some research, watch tutorials, and practice. Many people use coding and programming synonymously, which they are not. Coding is inside the realm of programming. It is merely the act of writing lines of code. While programming is coding plus problem solving, design, collaboration, innovation, long-term thinking, and more. Far too many new developers dive headfirst into writing code without considering critical factors that are in the realm of programming.
Bro, how do you do that?
Let's look at a simple example. You're making a snake game. Instead of diving straight into coding the game, take a step back. You need a plan. Define the rules and objectives of the game. Create a flowchart to visualize how players will progress through the game. How will you store game data, such as current score, high score, lives, etc. You don't need a completely concrete idea, but even a general idea of these things will be super beneficial compared to diving into coding right away. Once you have some code, make sure you're organizing everything into files. Make sure all features of the game are compatible with each other. If you're collaborating with other people, divide the labor equally. Communicate everything. Think about scalability and extra features. How many people will be playing this game at once? Difficulty levels? It's a lot of stuff. However, doing all these things will give you successful projects and accomplishments that'll stand out to employers and it'll make you better than the competition. This is a huge one, so listen up. Making coding projects is essential because they provide hands-on experience and offer several advantages that studying code and watching tutorials alone cannot fully replicate. Employers love when programmers make projects. Some examples of coding projects include an interactive website, a cool 2D or 3D game, a machine learning model, a web application, or anything that you have interest in and it'll grow you as a programmer. The more hands-on experience you have, better you'll stand out. Remember Timmy? He made all these amazing applications, but guess what? He never made a portfolio. For anyone who doesn't know, portfolio in coding is somewhere that you can upload all your projects, including the code behind them, which potential employers can see. You need one. Because what's the point of having amazing projects if your potential employers don't know that you have amazing projects? An easy way to create a portfolio is by going to github.com, logging in or creating an account, and clicking Create Repository. Have you ever heard the quote, "Your network is your net worth"? Networking is something that many people overlook, and it's not as difficult as you think. Let me explain. One way to start networking is by building an online presence. An online presence allows potential mentors, collaborators, and job opportunities to find you. Make a portfolio and use social media to get your name out there. Other ways to network are by simply talking to someone who's already in the tech industry or knows people that are. A great example is by talking to a teacher. Just show your teacher or someone else that you're interested and willing to learn more. Other ways to network are attending job fairs, attending coding competitions, enrolling in online courses, just to name a few. It's a lot easier getting a job through connections and references than it is just applying and praying for a response. And remember,